Bill Nye, he calls himself the science guy. He's actually a mechanical engineer. He's taking aim at climate change skeptics in a recent interview, saying, quote, climate change deniers, by way of example, are older. It's generational. So we're just going to have to wait for those people to age out, as they say. Age out is a euphemism for die. But it'll happen, I guarantee you. That will happen. Let's take a quick look at the oil company stocks, how they did today. ExxonMobil, Chevron, ConocoPhillips, BP, all ending the day in the red. Oil's been in a bit of a bear market. Energy stocks not doing any better. First Solar, SunPower, also ending the day down. With me now, the founder of ClimateDepot.com, he's Mark Morano. So, Mark, good to see you. Yes. People who disagree with you should just die.
Yeah, he went from, actually last year he was Bill Nye, the jail the skeptics guy. He actually agreed with Robert F. Kennedy Jr. that climate skeptics should be prosecuted and possibly go to jail for blocking action on climate change. And now he's upped the ante. He's now saying that we should all die in order to advance the global warming agenda. And I love the way he says, I can guarantee you that they will die. Well, he's guaranteeing that everyone's going to die at some point. So that's the science of Bill Nye. But this is very in line with the whole debate of intimidation and silence. And Bill Nye is the leader of that now, unfortunately. And he's got a big influence with young minds. And that's why he's so confident he can convert the young people to climate action. But he's having trouble with anyone his age and older because, frankly, they're wiser and they've experienced a lot, so they're less susceptible to his propaganda.
So no room for debate. It kind of shows how science can be a religion, you know, kill the heretics. I mean, but this guy, Bill Nye, again, he's an engineer. He's not a scientist. He has made controversial remarks before about climate change skeptics, suggesting that, you know, developed countries should penalize, maybe tax people who have too many children.
Yes.
I mean, that's going too far, right?
Yeah, in fact, it goes to this whole line. There's a new study out, too, saying we should have less kids. Bill Nye had the guy on his show who says that we should save our kids by not having them, essentially. Their kids are causing more climate change, which doesn't make sense. Bill Nye has been promoting that for a long time because there's actually studies in the climate change world that says that more global warming will put people less in the mood and therefore result in less kids. You know, it's just they've gotten to a point where they want to control our cars, our light bulbs, our energy, our transportation, and now they want to control family size, and they actually, if you disagree, they want you in jail or they're going to wait for you to die to impose this on society. It's not really science anymore. This is an agenda, and it's about, as we opened it saying, this is about controlling humans.
You're controlling, and you know what? It's also about the poorer nations in the planet. The underdeveloped nations who are not using the energy, and they don't have developed societies, and there's a lack of faith in the way that the free market and companies are reducing the carbon footprint by reducing GSEs, right?
Yeah, in fact, I had a movie last year called Climate Hustle. We feature Al Gore in the film talking about the developing world, saying we need, quote, fertility management, unquote. And he went on to lament about how Africa and developing countries are going to have a population explosion. Well, I mean, this is the issue. They're going after the most poor and vulnerable. They're denying them life-saving carbon-based energy, and they're basically trying to socially engineer 1 billion people who don't have running water and electricity. There's something to be said here. You know, if this is a scientific debate, fine, let's have the debate. And if it's a policy debate, fine, let's have the debate. Let's stop threatening to put people in jail. Stop threatening that there are other people, anyone in opposition is going to eventually die and that they'll win. This is not a healthy debate. It's as you said, the head of the UN climate panel actually said, quote, global warming is my religion, unquote. And if you understand that, that's the way they're acting here.
Mark Morano, good to see you. We love having you on. Come back soon.
Thank you. Appreciate it.